Hello, I'm Paul Livingston, and I'm bringing you a special documentary today, which is all about the local tagging problem and graffiti. I'll be telling you the hot spots and why they do it. I'll be giving you a local resident's view and a tagger's view, plus telling you what the council's doing to clear it up. Street gangs, muggings, carjackings, and even murder. These words are not usually associated with Wellington, but over the past year they've all happened. These are uncommon, but one thing that isn't is tagging, which is springing up all over the town. These so-called taggers are similar to the graffiti problem, which started in America, although the work is less of an art form and looks more like squiggles. Their work can be seen defacing buses, walls, and even houses. I spoke to one resident who was keen to air her views.
I think it's got to come down to the parents to be responsible for these young people as well. When they are caught, and hopefully the local police will be doing more foot patrols and catch the culprits, then I think it should go back to the parents, what they're like at school, if there's some meaningful tasks these kids could be doing in the borough.
The people who do this crime tend to be young and from deprived backgrounds. Much like the projects in America, the council estates in Wellington thrive on drugs and crime. Young people are sucked into it. They seem to be hitting out at the society, which hasn't helped them.
It does seem to be an increasing problem in not only our area, but many more, and I believe it's young people who go about these sprays.
These young people go around in groups and usually operate at night. But who's to know if they will strike out at someone passing by or someone who spots them? The council is fighting back with the graffiti squad. They're a four-man squad. They're armed with 3,000 square inch pressure washers, bicarbonate soda, and pots of paint. They start their shift at 8:30 in the morning and visit around 40 places across the borough during an average 9-hour shift. Although the council appear to be tackling the problem, the taggers themselves seem less bothered by the news.
It makes you feel all warm and it's wicked and it's bad. And it's cool. Especially when everyone else goes, look at that disgusting graffiti, and I just say it's art.
And let's hope this is not a view held by all taggers, because it's such a dangerous hobby. Some so-called artists will go to great lengths to get their tag seen. Some are in dangerous places, such as railway lines.
They might be seen in railway lines, and how these kids do it without getting themselves killed, I don't know. It's very, very dangerous for the kids as well.
Strong views there from a resident who is obviously concerned by the danger involved and is showing that she cares for their well-being.
Discipline as kids would have been sorted us out a bit, but we're not slaves to the system. I will go against it. We're not slaves to the system. We're not slaves to the system.
It makes me feel all warm and it's wicked and it's fat. And it's cool. Especially when everyone else goes, look at that disgusting graffiti, and I just say it's art. Wicked and it's fat.
We're not slaves to the system.
Many believe the culture is about getting respect and getting their tag seen. But I asked the question, what culture is it from?
Well, you ban it because it's part of our culture. The yacht culture.
Youth clubs like the one in Brownshaw seem to distract young people from a life on the street. But at night, when there's nothing to do, they often creep out of their houses and tag. How will the council cope with this problem? Well, there's no solution yet, but I hope they're working on something for the residents in Wellington.
Well, we do it because we feel like it. We've got nothing else to do. Me and my bedroom just go around, tag on property, some cars. Discipline as kids would have been sorted us out a bit, but we're not slaves to the system, and we'll go against it.
The council's efforts with the graffiti squad, a four-man team, can only be doing a certain amount of good, as there are millions of taggers out there and only four members of the graffiti squad. So I wonder how much good are they actually doing? I basically feel that these kids have somehow been let down by society they live in. We can't blame them because it's partly our fault. They need more entertainment and more clubs. In the end, it all comes down to money. We need to spend more money on them. If we don't, then they'll just end up defacing property and costing us money. So a sympathetic view should be brought upon these situations, or else it could explode into a graffiti tagging mega bomb explosion. Well, seasons will pass and fashions will change, but it seems graffiti is here to stay. And for the town of Wallington, it means war. However the residents feel, however much the council spends, there seems there will always be a gang of taggers ready to pounce on your wall and deface it. I leave you with the harsh views of one resident. The words are strong and the message is clear. Let's just hope it doesn't happen.
Very, very upset, as you can imagine. We've not lived here very long. We've had the wall built and the front of the house all patioed over, so surfaced over, and I was very, very upset to find the blue paint. It's not come off very easily. We're putting an insurance claim, but if I got the little beggars, I think I'd be very inclined to chop the hands off. That would stop them doing it. But
and on next week's show, I'll be talking about car park attendance. Surely something should be done about this, and the police is looking into it. So join in next week for car park attendance. Are they really the spawn of Satan? Love you, bye.